Hi guys, welcome to Meraki the Tribe. Guys, it's been very long since I have posted a video here on my channel, and I wanted to post a video, like a random reading, for anyone who is watching this. And it's not particular to any zodiac sign, or it is not limited to any timeline. So whenever you are watching this video is when you are supposed to see this video, and if the messages resonate with you, then that's good. Otherwise, let it go, guys, and let's see what's coming up for the viewers of this video. What are the messages are we getting for the viewers of this video? What are the important messages are we getting for the viewers of this video? Spirits, guides and angels, kindly guide me and help me deliver the messages, clear messages for the viewers of this video. This is a timeless reading, and use your own intuition, guys, and kindly like, subscribe and share the video if you feel like. And thank you for the support, guys. I'll begin. Okay, so yes, we are ready. King of Wands with Four of Swords. So the energy that is coming out here is of the fire energy, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. This is a very stable person who is very focused on their dreams and desires and goals. This can be you feeling very much in your power, feeling very bold and courageous. You feel very accomplished, or someone around you is feeling like this. This can be a masculine figure, like a father as well. Now, here is someone who is taking a break. I feel like saying someone is taking a creative break, as in someone was feeling some sort of a creative blockage, like a writer's block or something like that. So this person is taking a break, relaxing, lying down, taking some time off for themselves in order to feel rejuvenated, and in order to connect more deeply with their own self, so that they can continue working on their dreams and goals and desires in a very in a way which is true to them. And they are not getting carried away by the people around them, or the ideas and opinions of people around them. So that's what I'm getting here. It can also say that if there is a fire sign or a masculine figure in your life, that person is probably taking a break from either the relationship or from you. But it's not something like they have left you or anything. It's just that they want to relax and have time for themselves. So bottom of the deck is the Taurus card. So there can be something related to institution, school, court. So somebody is either working in an office, and that person can also be your boss. Maybe you are taking a break from your office, or you want to. Okay, let's see what's coming up for the people watching this video. So this is going to be a Four of Wands. So somebody is working towards their stability, saving money, or buying a new house, saving money for the house, or there is some sort of celebration, marriage, or somebody is taking their relationship to another level, like a more commitment oriented. Bottom of the deck here is the Nine of Swords. So maybe you want a commitment, or you are worried about a house that you are looking for, and you are up at night thinking about why and when, like why isn't happening and when is it going to happen. Someone is here worried about their stability, their But so far the cards that I'm getting here are very, very positive. So let me see what are these cards have to say. Okay, I'm going to read this as the reading. Overall energy here is that somebody is feeling victorious. Somebody feels that they have been recognized. Somebody feels that there is a reason for them to celebrate and party. There can be a job opportunity coming up for some of you, like a idea that you want to make concrete, you want to build upon that idea. I'm also getting here that there can be a clash between two people, like there can be a competition between two people. One person can be a little bit emotional and the other one can be a little bit bold and enthusiastic. While one is very connected to their soul, the other one is very eager to prove their worth, prove their talents. So one is very reserved and the other one is very show off sort of a person. There can be a face off between these two people. These two people can be anyone in your life. And I'm getting here that with the Capricorn card here, that there was certain sort of a restriction or some sort of a passion, emotional passion it could be, or it can be something related to anything that was holding you in a way that you felt restricted. Maybe it were your emotions towards somebody who was coming and going in your life. Like this person was not stable, but now you are gathering your courage. Can be a Leo person in your life, or you're gathering some courage to accept a offer which is being offered to you by the universe. This doesn't have to be a offer from a person to you. This is a offer from a universe to you, which you can you can take that offer and start building upon it, but it will require you some amount of effort. It will require you to tame your beast. This is the beast that you are taming, and this is the chain that you are breaking. So this can be some old habit of yours that is not serving you anymore, that you need to break out of. Okay? And I see that you will get recognition, because Six of Wands is your overall energy. Now, when another card that I have here is the Two of Wands. Two of Wands here is telling me that once you will get this opportunity in your life, you will start looking for ways to manifest that idea or that whatever has been given to you in a much more fulfilled way, which is more suited to you. Now there is a reconciliation or a coming together with friends. Like I said, there can be some sort of a celebration. There can be someone trying to come back in your life who wants to take risk, who wants to start something new, or this can be you who wants to take risk and start something new in your life. You don't care about what other people have to say or contribute here. You are very clear about your idea and whatever that has come to you. Ace of Swords and Ace of Pentacles. You are not holding yourself back. You are talking about how you want to take your dreams forward. And this is your family. I think you are telling your family as well, because it feels like a holiday situation where you are sitting with your family and telling them something, that you want to start something new, either with them or away from them. And you are very vocal about it. You are very expressive about it. I think think people are recognizing your potential here. They are being supportive. If they are not supportive, there is angels supporting you, because this card is supported by Temperance card here, which is very angelic card, and divine guidance is there. You just have to understand where are you coming from, what do you have currently, and where you can go from here. So that needs to be planned, well planned and executed. So let's see what is coming up. What's more is there. So I need 10 cards for a Celtic cross reading. 10 card Celtic cross reading. What are the messages coming in for my viewers? This is the second spread, guys. So either the first message resonated with you, or this is going to resonate with you, or both can resonate with you. Okay. What are the messages coming in for my viewers for 10 card Celtic cross? With the previous spread, I felt that you are trying to start something new with a new enthusiasm, and you are very focused and clear. You want to speak your truth, and you want to build upon something that is truly yours and which truly resonates with your soul. You are aware about the conflict and competition, but you are very focused on your victory. You are not getting deviated from your victory. Like I said, there is some competition that you are going to face, and also there is some sort of a reconciliation or second chances, or you had some project in mind that you already started, and then you left in between because of the competition or because of scattered energy. But now you are ready to defend yourself and your idea. You are pushing people away who are not supporting, and you are pushing your own distracted ideas and opinions that are not supportive of your dreams. And bottom of the deck here is the Leo card again. So this will give you some recognition, happiness and abundance, prosperity, joy. So keep working on what you are working on, guys. In fact it's very strange. If you guys know, I was about to shut down my channel in a way that I was saying that I won't be probably posting in the month of December 2018, and I'll see if I'll be posting in the year 2019. But then I couldn't stop myself from posting this video because I felt it's my duty and I need to give my dreams a chance, because if I won't give it, then who would? Okay, so we have a flipper here. Yes, there is movement, there is swift movement, there is positive messages that you are sending out in the universe. These can be your affirmations, these can be your love messages towards somebody. Either you're receiving them or you're giving out to somebody. There is movement, even though you're feeling that, you know, there is some restriction that you're facing, like you're not able to decide, you're confused, but that is happening because you are not listening to your heart, because this person has their heart closed. So that is the issue. So try to I'll suggest listen to heart chakra meditation on YouTube while sleeping. Just tune into that video on your earphone and help heal your heart chakra, basically. So just one last shuffle here. Okay, let's begin. So Devil card is coming up again. So maybe you are dealing with a Capricorn person here, or you are dealing with somebody who is materialistic or toxic. This person can be chaining you or holding you back from achieving or moving forward. This person can be addicted to you, or you are addicted to this person, or you are obsessing about a situation and you are not able to unlock or you know, detach yourself from a situation, you are obsessing about it way too much. So this is extra energy. This is thinking too much, drinking too much, texting too much, working too much, anything too much. This is that energy, and you're bound to that energy. You are workaholic, or you are a alcoholic, or you are a shopaholic, that sort of energy. What is your challenge? The Hierophant. So two major arcana here. So your challenge is that you need to move forward, you need to make some changes, because this is number 5, but you are not able to make those changes. This is number 15. The devil is number 15. So it will require you 3 times more effort in order to break away from this energy, which is toxic. And how you can break from it is that you need to get into a routine. You need to do dull things, like boring routine daily things, which are not so exciting, which are not so out there and you know, adventurous. It's really boring energy. You need to follow the rules, you need to follow the timetable. So you need to get into a habit. Basically, you need to develop new habits, and that is what you are not able to do because of, I guess, lack of self-discipline. So do that. And it's a very conventional card. It means system. So you need to get into a system in order to get away from this toxic energy, which is leaving you astray, which is leaving you depleted and drained. So yes, so like I said, you need 3 times more energy. You need to put 3 times more effort in order to break away from this energy. Whatever that you how much ever effort you are putting right now, triple it. Okay, now let's see what's grounding this. Okay, so like I said, some of you are here definitely dealing with an alcoholic person, or you yourself are stuck either in your fantasy or in your desires. You are hoping for something to come to you. You're hoping and desiring, and that has become toxic, because there is no end to wishing and fantasizing. You need to put in work, you need to put in effort. So there is some desire that you have, some emotional fulfillment that you need. You want to feel very full, like emotionally satisfied and fulfilled. Let's see what else comes up here. In your past, Page of Swords. Some of you were definitely either be dealing with a fire, I meant to say air sign, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. Either this person was stalking you, or you were stalking this person online, or this person wanted to give you some message, or you were doing some research or background check on this person. By the way, you could also be dealing with a Taurus. I don't know if I said that, but yeah. So the Page of Swords is someone who is very this person is very sly and sneaky. They want to give you some information, but they will wait for the right time, and they are looking for a right moment to deliver that information. This person may not know how to deliver this information. This can be you wanting to communicate with someone but not doing it because the timing is not right. Or the Hierophant here is also telling me that this can be in your marriage, or it can be related to court or office issues. Because Capricorn is very duty and work oriented card. Here is the Capricorn. So maybe you were waiting to hear from somebody in the past. Your another energy here is Two of Wands. So Two of Wands here is telling me that like I said, you are looking forward, you want to move forward, you want to take something forward in your life, and you're planning where to go from here. You have limitless possibilities, endless possibilities, and wherever you choose to go, you can go there and you can start building. So you're thinking about where to go from here, you're making plans, you want to move forward. Now, your future energy is the King of Swords. So this person who was in past Page of Swords, who could be dealing with addiction or who could be doing something extra like a workaholic, this person is now trying to speak to you very straightforward. Or this is you who is taking on this person's energy, and this is Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. This person can be trying to look at the person here, very strict, very straightforward, no nonsense person. This can be a judge or a lawyer, court case or something of that nature. This is someone very cutting with their word, cold, does not pay attention to emotions. This can be you who is trying to finally detach from somebody whom you were emotionally very connected to. So you are being very strict with your own self or with this person, because you want to be very clear headed. And this is someone very, very, very clear, logical, rational. So maybe you are trying to, you know, get closer to your logical side, listen to your logical side, or you will be dealing with somebody like this in future. You come up in your reading as Nine of Wands. This is someone who is defending themselves, someone who has been fighting for themselves, someone who is fighting for a cause, and they will fight till they die. They are very adamant, they are not giving up. So maybe you were fighting for something and that was your challenge. Why are you fighting for something which is futile? Something you're doing something over and over again. And you can be a little bit fearful and defensive, blocking people out or isolating yourself. So I don't think how that is going to help you. But you are in a cycle here where you are hurting yourself is what I'm feeling. And 9 and 9 here, I'm getting that there needs to be some cycle that comes to an end. You need to come to 10 of Cups and 10 of Wands, where take responsibility and just finish the work that needs to get done, and you will have wish fulfillment and completion here. So yeah, someone around you is King of Cups. So someone around you is somebody who basically is very emotionally stable, can be a Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, very emotionally stable, and they are either, maybe they just see you, they are not looking at you definitely. So whoever this is, you are not looking at them, you are defensive, and even they are not looking at you. This can be a family member who is not paying attention, or it feels like you're angry with somebody who does not even know that you're angry with them. You're defending yourself from somebody who doesn't even understand what's going on with you. Okay? Because they're not looking here. Maybe this person spoke something harsh to you and it makes you defensive, but they didn't realize that they have caused you that much, that much turmoil within you. Okay, this card comes up again. So you're hoping for a victory here. You want victory over this person who has caused you hurt, or you want to be recognized, you want to be appreciated. This is your hope and desire. You want to be victorious. You want either your family or friends to recognize you, or you want your work to be rewarded. You want to be credited for your effort that you have put in. You want to be celebrated. That is your desire. Your outcome is the Wheel of Fortune, so I'm getting that there is not much that you can do except for the fact that you are supposed to get into a routine or a system that you are probably not able to do because of lack of self-discipline or lack of focus, because rest everything else is in universe's hand and you can't do much about it. This wheel will turn when the time is right. You can't rush it, but good things are coming your way definitely. Guys, there's a train that is going to pass by, so excuse me for the noise. So let's clear, you know, I think this is also about good luck and your something shifting in your life and changing. Like whatever the situation was, it will soon change, but it will happen in its own time. Meanwhile, you will have to focus on how you can bring change in your own daily routine life and how you can develop certain habits that will help you escape this obsessive pattern that you are having here. If you have a choice between two people here, by the way, bottom of the deck here is the Six of Cups. So you might be addicted to even your past. You are thinking about your past and you are addicted to your past because it was very nice, and you are thinking about all the good memories from the past, and you are sort of, you know, fantasizing, and you wish it could come back. But there was some you know, battle and some sort of bit of bitterness there. There was heartbreak. So yes, I'm getting that in future, if you have a choice between two people, then you are choosing King of Swords, which is air sign person who is very logical. But in your surrounding, there is also somebody who is emotionally very stable and grounded, and they can provide you some support. Now let's clarify Wheel of Fortune at least. Two of Pentacles and... okay. So Wheel of Fortune here, the outcome is being clarified by two of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, and the Page of Pentacles. So what I'm getting here is that someone is trying to juggle two people, or somebody is trying to steal some opportunity from somebody. So this can be you trying to steal from yourself because you're not able to balance things in your life, or somebody will try to cheat you by offering you something which is very less and you need more. So be careful of that. And I'm getting that you need to balance, or you're trying to balance between two people. You're trying to make that choice. You hope for true love. You are hoping for true love and recognized by your true love, but and you feel that this person has a lot of options, and I am also getting that probably the person that you are dealing with has a lot of options, or you want to have a lot of options and you are a little bit confused about your options. Page of Cups and the Happy Stress. Somebody around you is very secretive, and they do want to offer you love and comfort and emotional fulfillment. They are quite, you know, King of Cups, Page of Cups, and the High Priestess. They are quite knowledgeable and secretive. They do want to offer you love, or they want to just apologize to you. But you are very defensive and you want justice, and you are rejecting their offer. But it can be a Leo that you are rejecting, or a Libra. You want justice in this situation, and probably this person also sees that you are being very strong, and you are you can reject them, and you will not accept their boring offer. If the offer is not enough, you will probably reject them. And if you are dealing with a court issue, You're being very strong, and I'm sorry to say, but I'm getting that maybe with the court decision you are not satisfied and happy. King of Swords is... Okay, so if there is a air sign in your life, they are either very confused or you are very confused about an air sign. This person keeps you trapped, and this person probably acts single. They act single and they are not able to decide if they want to be with you, or this can be you who is not able to comprehend this person, what they are like, and if you want to be with them, or you're not able to make that decision. Your advice probably is that just be straightforward and focus on yourself, be clear and communicative, and say things as you feel, and be very straightforward. Don't get emotional. I'm also getting here that somebody is a little bit focused on money in future, like their own self-worth and their own stability and their own money. Okay, maybe this is you working on your money aspect. Now, like I said, this is the Ten of Wands, so you will now try to move from Nine of Wands to the Ten of Wands, where you will try to drop this burden as soon as possible. You want to drop the burden and you want to begin a new journey. You want to start a new journey. Yes, in past you were looking for some justice, some fairness, somebody, you had invested in somebody and you want to balance it out. You want equal reciprocation, give and take. And then you are wishing for love and a soulmate union. Through all this, you are just wishing for a soulmate union. Probably you want to be with a Gemini person. And your obstacle is you are not able to overcome a situation which has already been lost. Basically, you have already grieved on something, and you are not able to get over a loss that has already been done. This is again number 5. I'll clarify it again. Yes, you are still stuck and upon something which is futile, which has not delivered you anything good, something you had invested in your time, your money, your nourishment, and it has not been fruitful. Could have been with a Taurus person or a Capricorn person. There is somebody probably around you who is a little bit sexually attracted towards you, and they are just offering you something little bit, like, you know, physical comfort. Can be a Leo and it makes you happy. It can be a Scorpio as well, but it makes you happy initially, that whatever this situation is, which is very passionate and stuff, but it will come to an end, or it will go through some transformation, or you need to go through some transformation, because it's very shallow whatever that is being offered to you, and it does make you happy. It can be with a Leo, Scorpio, or any Capricorn or a fire sign, because ultimately it will put you through sleepless nights, and you will probably and you want this. You want a family union or something like that, but that's not what this person is offering you right now. And again, the card here, bottom of the deck, is power struggle. Some sort of power battle is going on. Give me one advice card for this reading. One advice card, please. Why? I'm getting here that okay, so this opportunity is here again. I'm getting here that in order to build upon this opportunity and have this stability in your life, like the home that you need, the place that you need to rest and be cozy in, you need to become very bold and courageous and follow your heart and your own happiness. This queen is sitting with her sunflower in her hand. You need to be bold, you know, that courageous enough, and you should be able to live alone, even though it feels chilly outside, somebody left you behind. This is the same energy which is your blockage energy. This is the 555. So I was telling you triple your efforts. This is the same 555. This is card number 5. This is 5 and this is 5. And this is card number 15. Okay? So there is some codependence issue here, some sort of codependency. So in order to break away from that codependency, you need to follow some sort of either a spiritual guru or some sort of get yourself enrolled in an institution, get a job or something, and get out of this living in the past sort of energy, the loss that you already had. Because look here, you will find your soulmate eventually, because these two cups here are behind you which are not broken. So you will get out of that situation, but right now if you are in this situation where you feel very alone, lonely basically, and don't feel appreciated, you want to feel appreciated, you want to have love like we saw here, you want to feel celebrated and appreciated, and you want to love in your life, you need to be okay with this situation where you are alone, because that is when you will be independent and focused on yourself, build upon yourself in future. Look, in future you have to have all these things all by yourself, not dependent on anybody else, and then build your own stability. Build your own stability. And like I said, your outcome was that luck will be in your favor, but there is something that you will face here, like a choice between two people. Either somebody is offering you something deceptive, or they are not offering you something enough, like they are not offering you a lot. This is Page of Pentacles, somebody who is juggling two people. So don't settle for anything less than that you want. Build things for yourself. So we started from this card and we need to reach here. Okay, now I'll close this reading here. Okay guys, I hope it resonated, and I know it's a very long reading, but I enjoyed doing it. I hope you I hope you resonated with it. And I'll pull one of these cards. This is Sacred Rebel deck. Give me an energy and messages for the reading that I just did. What is the advice, or what is the message? What is the advice and the message? Okay. Your message is focus on the light. Look at the sunflower here again, and Queen of Wands also had the sunflower in her hand. So focus on the light, focus on the positive, focus on the one more thing I'm gonna show you here. Shock of the new. This lady also has sunflower in her hair. Shock of the new. So maybe initially you will feel like, no, I cannot do this all by myself, and this is something new for me, and it's taking me so much effort and stuff. But bottom of the deck here is dream a beautiful dream. Okay, so I think this reading was about following your dreams and ideas, and not settling for anything less, not getting scared and desperate because you are feeling alone. Okay, and not settling for anything less, basically. That's the bottom line. So guys, I'll see you again. I hope this reading was helpful, and please like and subscribe, or drop me a comment. I'll truly, truly appreciate it. It would mean a lot to me if you can write to me whatever that you feel like. Okay, see ya.